This video contains minor angels of the Zaraman spoilers. With the Angels of the Zaraman update, we've got new evolving weapons, the Incarnate weapons. This video, I'll focus on the melee weapon, the Prados. Let's explore its evolutions and see how you can get the most out of it. I'm the Kengineer, let's solve a practical problem. The Prados, a pair of slash heavy tomfas, is the last of the weapons currently available from the Holdfast, requiring rank 4 with them before you can purchase the blueprint. Alternatively, you can buy the blueprint from other players. There are 5 evolution stages, each connected to an easy challenge. Evolution 1 requires just 100 kills with the Prados, unlocking the Incarnate mode. Evolution 2 requires you to activate the Incarnate mode 6 times. It doesn't have to all be in one mission though, which is probably for the best. Evolution 3 needs you to do heavy attacks 3 times against Thrax enemies. You don't have to kill them with it, just a hit is good enough. Evolution 4 requires you to close 12 ruptures in Void Flood, and Evolution 5 requires you to do any mission with 3 Incarnate weapons equipped. Unlike the Incarnate guns, the Incarnate mode of the Prados doesn't change how it functions. Instead, you activate the Incarnate mode by heavy attacking with 5 times or higher combo to gain a buff for 90 seconds. This buff increases your range by 2 meters and your attack speed by 40%, both of these additive to mods. In contrast to the guns as well, the timer runs down even if you're not using the Prados. Evolutions 2 through 5 all offer modest buffs or utility features to the Prados, adding to how you use it rather than being a key factor. Evolution 2 opens up the options of 50% increased slam radius, 20% higher attack speed, or 20% higher sprint speed and slide. Evolution 3 offers either 4 extra combo per enemy hit by slam radial damage, 1.5 meter range increase for slide attacks, or 15 initial combo. Evolution 4 gives you the option of a reduction in the minimum combo to activate Incarnate mode, down from 5 times to 3 times, or a choice of 2 movement bonuses, either 100% stronger double jumps, or 30% bonus to particle velocity. Finally then at Evolution 5, we can pick up either 50% heavy attack efficiency after you get a slide kill, 100% faster heavy attack wind-up speed, or collecting ammo gives you 5 combo. By and large then, the bonuses offered by these evolutions are supportive of the Prados in various playstyles, or otherwise provide passive bonuses to your movement, but they're nothing too crazy. Certainly no 2000% damage bonus like we see on the guns. Looking at the base weapon itself, if we compare it to the Cronan Prime, you'd be forgiven for thinking the Prados is just worse. The Cronan Prime has better critical chance, much higher status chance, and higher damage without losing that slash heavy distribution. However, the evolution buffs on the Prados are giving you increased range and attack speed, two stats always buffed on the Cronan Prime through mods. This means we can either go all out on range and speed, or swap out those mods for more damage and utility. In practical testing, I found the Prados to be very close to Cronan Prime, if not just a little bit better at killing enemies. Most crucially, the Prados gives you more modding flexibility, as well as more utility bonuses. You can go about building the Prados in 4 main ways, each of which guide which evolutions you use. The first build is a Prados-only combo build. Using the innately high slash and combining it with a small amount of viral, Prados can tear through most enemies without needing a support weapon. The downranked Virulent Scourge and Vicious Frost here is important. With downranked mods, 61.5% of our damage is slash. If you hit an enemy 6 times, which Sovereign Outcast makes very easy to do on the forward combo, you'd apply an average of 4.2 slash procs and 1.5 viral procs. Because viral procs make slash deal more damage, this is roughly equivalent to 9 unboosted slash procs. If we were to switch instead to using fully ranked 60-60 mods, our status chance increases a bit, but the slash proportion plummets from 61.5% to only 36.4%. Looking again at 6 hits, we'd now expect only 2.9 slash procs with 4.3 viral procs. That's equal to about 8 unboosted slash procs. It may not seem like a huge difference, but it shows how too much viral can be a bad thing. Having less viral means we can proc slash more often and more reliably, improving your kill speed. For this combo build, I'd recommend using the evolutions Drifting Grace for sprint speed, Reaching Lunge for slide attack range, Evolved Ascension for particle velocity, and Transfigure Momentum for heavy attack efficiency on activating Incarnate mode. I personally don't value the 2 slam evolutions, both because tomfas don't struggle to gain combo, and because slam radial damage is barely useful outside of the basic star chart. Now if you have a primer weapon, such as an Epitaph or Kuva Nucor, you can use this second combo build. We've removed the viral mods, as viral should be on your primer, allowing us to instead mod for more attack speed. The dash polarity slot is a flex slot on this build. You can go for relentless combination to make gaining combo even easier, or Karnis Mandible to further increase the number of slash procs you land, or use an elemental mod if you're against a corpus or infested, toxin for the corpus or heat for the infested. If you do choose to add an element, make sure there's something different on your primer for improved effect and condition overload, of course. For this build's evolutions, I suggest again using Drifting Grace, Reaching Lunge and Evolved Ascension, but for Evolution 5, it's your choice of either Transfigured Momentum or Universal Readiness. Because you're using a primal weapon, you're constantly going to be in need of a small amount of ammunition, and that's going to keep triggering Universal Readiness. Not only will that keep giving you 5 combo every now and then, but that also resets your combo timer, especially useful if you're not using Narumon. Now, if instead you want to go for a heavy attack approach, this heavy combo build will suit you well. Because we've got both Reflex Coil and Focus Energy here for a heavy attack efficiency, we can switch the 5th evolution over to Kinetic Harmony for heavy attack windup speed. With that in play, there's no need to use the Amalgam version of Organ Shatter. As before, combine this with Drifting Grace, Reaching Lunge, and Evolved Ascension. If you're more confident in landing kills while sliding though, you can stick with a Transfigured Momentum evolution and Amalgam version of Organ Shatter. This allows you to trade out Reflex Coil for either an Elemental mod for more damage, Karnis Mandible for the defensive set bonus, or Dispatch Overdrive to gain bonus movement speed. This can be a more powerful approach, but comes with the extra requirement of getting those slide attack kills. If you heavy attack and then slide just moments after casting the heavy attack, that can kill an enemy whilst you are sliding, which will not only trigger the buff from Transfigured Momentum, but it will also save the combo from the heavy attack you just used. It can be a bit tricky to do, but once you get into the flow, it can certainly save you combo. Lastly then, if you want to go pure heavy attack, with no need to build even a little combo, you can use this fourth build. We trade out Blood Rush for Corrupt Charge, Focus Energy for Killing Blow, and Reflex Coil for again our choice of the other dash polarity mods. Here, the Adept Reflexes evolution for plus 15 combo is a must-have. Kinetic Harmony for heavy attack windup speed is an obvious pickup, and then it's your choice of either Evolved Ascension's Particle Velocity or Swift Transmute to save having to build combo for Incarnate Mode. Regardless of the build you take, the Prados is one of the stronger melee weapons in the game at the moment, able to keep up at the higher levels. On top of that, it also comes with its movement buffs, allowing you to run faster, slide faster, and jump further. This is the third video in the Incarnate Weapon series, so make sure you check out the other two as well. The guns have incredibly powerful evolutions which don't work how you might expect. And as always, jump far, slash hard, and fight well, Tenno.